If you're looking for a simple memos and note-taking app that makes great use of the touch screen of the tablet, you can't go past Specfics for simplicity of use and great functions. Let's take a look.
So when you first open the app, you get to this screen where you've got some notes listed under sections of today, this week, or any day. Basically, if you want to make a new note in any of the sections, you drag down under that section and it adds in a new note. So you can put in a note title and put all the detail in there. In the next section, you can basically either do some drawings with a pencil, which go onto your note, or if you like, you can add in or take a photo. So I'll choose a photo and add that in as my background. You can move and scale the photo and then click on the Use tab. Once you've finished your note, go back to your main screen and it appears there in that section. Now what you'll notice here is there's some notes that are labelled as work and there are some notes that are labelled as personal. If you actually go to the left, you can see right down the left edge here there's a tab called Settings. You can go across and see you've got various groups. If I want to make a new group, you can see there's a little arrow with a plus. I can drag down and make a new group there. So I might make a new group called Fitness and you can click Done. And if I want to see what items are in a particular group, I can tap on that group and it takes me across to the group screen. Now this group screen is actually to the right of the opening screen. So when we opened up, we came to this screen. We dragged left for the settings, but if we go to the right, you can actually get all of the notes under their various groupings. Now I just made the fitness group, so if I wanted to add a note here, once again, drag down in that section and it'll make a new note for me. So maybe I want to do some sit-ups today and we can do a stick figure of somebody doing some sit-ups. There we go, looks a bit weird. Alright, so I've got my notes there. Now before I made a note under work that I possibly want to put under personal. So this one, shopping, I said it was work, but that's not work. That's personal. So if I want to put them in a different group, basically I go to this group screen, grab the note and just drag it across and it changes the group for me. Okay, so that's the way to make new notes, either on the group screen or if you don't want to do it on the group screen, you can go back to your central screen and do today, this week or any day. If we go back to the left hand screen, you've got completed notes or overdue notes. So let's complete a note. If we tap on it and then you click on the tick, that sends it to completed section. So now if I go to the completed section, you can actually move notes between completed and overdue. But if you want to delete your completed notes, once again drag down on that group and you can choose to delete all of those notes. So delete. Now from this central screen, once the notes are past their due date, so if there were notes for today and we're now past that date, they'll appear under the overdue tab and you can do two things. If you want to restore that note, you basically pull down on that tab and it restores it back to your main screen, and if you want to get rid of the note altogether, as we showed you before, you can drag it out of the overdue column, you can put it into the completed column. As mentioned, you can link up with Evernote, so I've signed in, it's now syncing my notes across to Evernote, so you can keep track of all your notes wherever you might be. So fantastically simple notes reminders app, I guess, keep track of your specific notes, organize them into various groups, and has that wonderful feature where you can sync across to Evernote.
So I really like the feature that's coming into a lot of apps these days where you drag down on a particular menu to add items, and the ability to just to drag memos and notes between categories is also fantastic, as well as the linking with Evernote. I'd love to know what you think. Head across to the Facebook page at iPadagogy. Don't forget to follow the Twitter feed at i_pedagogy, and remember to subscribe to see more excellent video reviews of apps for use in education.